Hello, my dear students. I hope everyone is in good health. Okay, students. Last time, in the previous class, we have started with chapter 5. Your chapter 5 was solids, liquids and gases. Today, we will start with chapter 6. And chapter 6 is how plants make food. Okay, how plants make food? Plants make food through the process of photosynthesis. They make food in their leaves. Plants are called autotrophs. Why are plants called autotrophs? Because plants prepare food. Okay, that's why they are known as autotroph. Only green plants which contain chlorophyll, they can prepare their own food. And it prepares its food through the process of photosynthesis. Okay, so when I come to the lesson, I will explain what is photosynthesis. Before we start with the lesson, you have to solve this small puzzle out here. What you'll have to do, you'll have to circle the ones that we get from plants. I will solve two of them, like here fish. Fish you do not get from plants, it comes under animals. Okay, so this is an animal, that's why you will not circle. Oil, we get from plants, so we will circle it. Okay, the rest you will have to do it. Which we get from plants, only those you will circle it. Plants are important part of our life. We already know that they are the only living things that can prepare their own food using water, air and sunlight. This process is called photosynthesis. So what is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis, it is a process in which green plants, what they do? They use sunlight to make their own food. And it is necessary for life on earth. Without it, there would be no green plants, and without green plants, there would be no animals. Photosynthesis, it requires what? It requires sunlight, chlorophyll, water, and carbon dioxide gas. Chlorophyll is a substance in all green plants, especially in leaf. Okay, it's green in color. Why? Due to the pigment, chlorophyll. Photosynthesis starts when chlorophyll, it absorbs energy from sunlight. And green plants use this energy to change water and carbon dioxide into oxygen and nutrients called sugar. This is the process of photosynthesis. And plants use some of the sugar and store rest of them, while oxygen, which is released in the air, are being used by humans. Okay, so this is actually the process of photosynthesis. And sunlight and air, they are absorbed by the leaves. And roots, what they absorb? They absorb water and minerals. Food made by the plants is not only used by them, but also eaten by human beings and animals. So which food we get from the plants? Plants also use it, as well as humans and animals also use it. Now you have to know an important term. What's the meaning of synthesis? Synthesis means to put together. Okay, the term synthesis means to put together. And photo means light. So, photosynthesis means putting together with light. What's the meaning of photosynthesis? It means putting together with light. Okay, these might come in one word in your exam. So, please go through these terms. Okay, next, structure of leaf. We see leaves are of different size, shapes. Okay, some are big in size. Some are very small in size, like banana leaf. It's big in size. Coconut leaf also is big in size. Whereas tulsi leaf and coriander leaves, they are small in size. Similarly, other leaves also. There are different leaves, okay, which comes in different size and shapes, either big or small. Next. In spite of diversity in plants, all leaves have same basic part. Means there are different kinds of leaves with different size, shapes, okay, but they have similar parts. Okay, first is like leaf blade. What is leaf blade? It is the flat surface of a leaf. Okay, the flat surface of the leaf is called a leaf blade. Now you see here, what is leaf blade? Is the flat surface of the leaf. So the flat surface in a leaf is known as the leaf blade. In this leaf, this is the leaf blade. Okay, the flat surface of the leaf is known as the leaf blade. And it's even known as what? Leaf blade is even known as the lamina. Okay, it is broad and flat. And in the leaf blade, what happens? Photosynthesis occurs. Photosynthesis occurs in which part of the leaf? On the leaf blade. Now you see here, this is the midrib. Okay, the middle, you can see a line. This is the midrib. At the center, this is the midrib. And it's even known as the midvein. It has a midrib at the center, which is the main vein. Okay, and from its side, from the main vein, from the side, other veins come out. These are known as the side veins. Okay, it's known as the veins. This is known as the midrib. And the ones which come out from the side, they are known as the veins. Okay, so this is your leaf blade. From it, in it, you have the midrib and you have the veins. Now you see the leaf stalk. What is the leaf stalk? It joins the leaf blade to the stem of the plant. This is the leaf stalk. Okay, it joins the leaf to the stem. Now from here we'll have the stem. So this is the stalk. Okay, this part is the stalk. This is also the stalk. All right, so which joins the leaf, I mean the leaf blade, it connects to the stem, that is known as the leaf stalk. On close look at the leaf, we will see thin lines on it. This is the vein. Just before a while I've said these are the veins. They help. What is the function of veins? They help the foot to move from the leaf to the stem. Okay, this is the function of the vein. What is the function? They help in moving the foot from the leaf to the stem. Usually each leaf has a main thicker vein at the center, that is the midrib. Okay, so this is the midrib. The center one is the midrib. Small openings called stomata are present on the underside of the leaf. On what happens? On the underside of the leaf. Okay, here if you see, you cannot see with naked eyes. You need a microscope. Through that you can see the stomata. Alright, what is stomata? It is an opening on the underside of the leaf. And through stomata, what happens? The plant, they absorb carbon dioxide for photosynthesis and they even release oxygen. Okay, it is through the stomata that plants, they absorb carbon dioxide and then they give out oxygen as a byproduct. What is the meaning of byproduct? It's something that is formed during making something else. Okay, so that is the meaning of byproduct. Its stomata is composed of what? They are composed of two guard cells surrounding an opening known as the stomata, is a stoma. Okay, this is the stoma or the stomatal pore, and these are the guard cells. These bean shaped ones are known as the guard cells. Its stomata, here you see the picture. Its stomata, it consists of two guard cells. Guard cells are the bean shaped cells that surrounds the stoma. Okay, stomata, it consists of minute or small pore called stoma. Okay, this one, the pore is known as the stoma. Stoma is surrounded by a pair of guard cells, and guard cells, they control, what's the function of guard cell? They control the opening of the pore and even closing of the pore. Okay, that is the opening or closing of the pore, stoma, by changing its shape. That is, it becomes thick or even it shrinks. They become thick and they even shrink. Through this way, the pore opens and closes. What's the function of the stomata? Okay, it is to exchange gases by opening and closing the pore, and it helps to even remove excess of water if it's present in the leaf. The removal of excess of water from the leaves in the form of water vapor. It allows intake of carbon dioxide and outtake of oxygen during process of photosynthesis. Stomata, it remains open during the daytime and closed during the nighttime. These are the functions of stomata. Actually, it's not given in your book, but I have explained you for your clear understanding. Okay, next is leaf. Leaf are the food factories. Why is leaf called the food factories? Because it prepares food. Thus, leaf is known as the food factory of a plant. Have you ever wondered why plants need many green leaves? Why? Because actually to make food, that's why they require many green leaves. Leaves are green in color because they contain a green pigment called chlorophyll. So leaves are green in color. Why they are green in color? Because of the presence of the green pigment. The green pigment is known as chlorophyll. Chlorophyll helps plant to make their food in the sunlight. So in the presence of sunlight, what it does? It helps the plant to make food. The food prepared in the leaves is in the form of glucose. So what's the food prepared? It is the glucose. Okay. I have already explained you what is photosynthesis. It's the process in which plants make their own food. Okay, and now you see here, for photosynthesis to take place, following things happen simultaneously. What are the things happen? Water is absorbed by the roots and they are carried by the stem to the leaves. So what happens first? Water, it is absorbed by the roots and carried by the stem and it reaches the leaves. Light falling on the leaves, they are absorbed by chlorophyll. Okay, so here you see in this picture, what happens first one? Water is absorbed by the roots, then it goes through the stem to the leaves. Okay, and the light which falls on the leaves, it is absorbed by what? By the green pigment called chlorophyll. Carbon dioxide is absorbed into the leaf through stomata. So I have already clearly explained you what is stomata. Okay, through this hose, through the stomatal pore, what it receives? Carbon dioxide is absorbed. And as the food gets prepared, oxygen is produced as a byproduct. Already I have said what is byproduct? Something that is formed during making something else. So they are preparing food. Along with this, what is produced? Oxygen gas is also being produced and released. It is released out of the leaf through the stomata. So oxygen is released through the stomata. Okay, now next we will see what happens to the food made by the plants. Now you know the plants, they make food, right, during the process of photosynthesis. After the food is made by the plants, what happens? Some of the food made by the plant is used for its own self. That means plant, they themselves use it. The plant derives from this food the energy to perform various activities and also uses this food to grow. So they use for their own self. For what purpose? That is for different activities. What are the activities? That is to make food. That is for making food, for transportation of food, water and minerals between the different parts of the plant. Okay, so these are the activities what it does. That is to make food and for the transportation of the food. So for these activities, what they do? They use the food. Okay, and then what happens? Extra food which is left back, it is stored in different parts of the plant. And which are the parts of of the plant in which the extra food is stored? They are stored in the fruits, roots, stem, flowers, seeds. Okay, in the form of starch, they are stored in these different parts of the plant. Animals, they eat this food stored from the different parts of the plant. And this energy, it is the energy they get from this food is basically of solar energy that was absorbed by the leaves during the process of photosynthesis. Actually, what happens? The energy they got from this food is actually the solar energy which was absorbed by the plants, that is the leaves. Okay, in the plants, the leaves, they used the sunlight during the process of photosynthesis. Okay, so indirectly the energy is being transferred to the other living animals, that is the animals, by eating the food, okay, which were the extra food were stored in the different parts of the plant. Okay, this is how the solar energy is being transferred to the animals. Same goes even with humans also. We also eat the extra food. Now, the food, they contain starch, right? Different food materials, they contain starch. Okay, so that is an experiment how you can see the presence of starch. Okay, but what you will need is, you need iodine to do the experiment. What is iodine? It's a brown colored liquid. Okay, it's a brown colored liquid, that is iodine. Through this, using this iodine, you can do the experiment to test the starch. In the experiment, what you will do, you will take a slice of potato. Okay, it's potato is your food item, right? So you will take a slice of potato, and on the slice of potato, what you will do, you will add iodine drops. Okay, what you will see in it? The brown color, right? Put a drop of iodine on the slice of potato. What you will see, iodine will change its color from brown to blue black color. See, from the color brown color, it will change to a blue black color. So if it changes to blue black color, that means the food item contains starch. This experiment you can do with different food items, like on fruits, on vegetables, rice, atta, chapati, bread, dal. So on different food items you can do this experiment to see the presence of starch. If the brown color changes to blue black color, that means it contains starch. Next, energy flow in living organisms. This already I have discussed a while. Okay, how energy flows, the solar energy, how it's reaching the animals and humans, I've already explained the same thing. Okay, all living things need energy to stay alive. So to stay alive we need energy and to perform our day-to-day activities. Where does this energy come from? This comes from the food we eat. Okay, so from the food we eat we get the energy. Food is prepared by the green plants, and due to the presence of chlorophyll in there, due to the presence of chlorophyll in the leaves, the green plants, what they do, they trap the solar energy during the process of photosynthesis and make their food. They store extra food in different parts of plant. When humans and animals eat the plant parts, the energy of the sun is passed on to them. This is how energy flows from sun to the plant and then to animals and human being. Simple. Well, it's very simple. That is, plants, they use sunlight to prepare food, and the extra food, it is stored in different parts of plants. So when humans and animals, they eat it, the energy of sun is passed on to us, that is on humans also and animals. Thus energy, it flows from sun to the plants and from plants to animals and human beings. Okay, this is how the energy, it flows in living organisms. Interdependence of plants and animals. What is interdependence of plants and animals? How it is depending on each other? Now, it is very important to maintain interdependence of plants and animals. There should be interdependence of plants and animals, because it will help in the balance in nature. Okay, to have the balance in nature, there should be interdependence of plants and animals. Now, nature keeps a balance between all living things on the earth. Let us see how it happens, how this balance is happening. That is, animals and humans, they breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon dioxide. Plants, again, they use the carbon dioxide for preparing their food and give out oxygen as byproduct taken out by animals and human beings. What's happening is, we humans and animals, what we do, we breathe in oxygen, and what do we release? We release carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide is used up by the plants to prepare the food. Okay, so plants, they use carbon dioxide to prepare food, and then what they release? They release the oxygen, which is again absorbed by animals and human beings. So that's how there is balance between plants and animals in the nature. If either one will not be there, there will be no balance in nature. Okay, so this is how we breathe and we release the gases. Next, animals eat plants and prevent them from growing well. So if there are no animals, there will be full of plants and there would be destruction in balance in nature. So animals, what they do, they eat the plants, and when they die, what happened to their bodies? They get decomposed, and then this after decomposition, what happens? Minerals are being added to the soil from the dead bodies. Okay, from those decomposed dead bodies, what happens? Minerals are being added to the soil that are very essential for the growth of the plants. This is how balance is there in the nature. Okay, because animals, they eat plants. Okay, and in return, what happens when animals die? They decompose and they provide minerals for the growth of the plant. So there should be a balance in the nature, and it happens due to interdependence of plants and animals. Our next topic is need for protection of plants and animals. Why we need to protect the plants and animals? It is to maintain balance in nature. So to maintain the balance in nature, we have to protect the plants and animals. Now what humans are doing in last few decades, we have seen what they're doing. They're cutting down trees in large number. For what purpose? For agriculture purpose, for making homes, to build factories on those places. Yes, business purpose also people are doing this. Okay, they are cutting large number of trees, and this cutting down of trees, this is known as deforestation. So this has to be stopped. Okay, cutting down of trees has to be stopped to protect our nature. Deforestation, it even destroys the natural habitat of many animals. Now, you know animals, they live in forest. And if you destroy the forest, that is cut down the trees, where will this animal go? Okay, they will become homeless. Alright, so you need to stop this deforestation. And what happens? Besides deforestation, what others are doing? Humans, they are even killing animals for their satisfaction. Okay, like elephants, they are killing for what? For the teeth. Tigers, they are killing for the skin. Peacock, they are attacking for the feathers. Okay, so these are the different things how humans are attacking the animals. So animals also need to be protected. We have seen that how the balance in nature are being destroyed due to deforestation. First we have seen, next we have seen the killing of animals. And if animals are being killed, what happens? Some animals, they are already extinct. What are extinct animals? Those animals which are not found anymore on the earth now. We do not get to see those animals. We see only the pictures of them. We cannot see in real, like dodo birds, Siberian crane, West African black rhinoceros. Okay, they have completely destroyed from the earth, disappeared from the earth. Okay, these are known as the extinct animals. And why this happened? Because of killing of the animals. And now, it's really bothersome and really worried. Okay, because what? Since humans are killing animals, there are few animals which are endangered. That is, means they are in danger. Only a few numbers are there. And if they are again killed, completely it will be. I mean, those animals will disappear again completely. They will also become extinct. Okay, such animals which are endangered animals, they are like tiger, rhinoceros, lion. Okay, they may completely disappear from the earth if we do not protect them now. Okay, so we have to protect and save our animals. Now, government have come out with different ways how to conserve plants and animals. First, we'll see what are the ways. First is Project Tiger. What is Project Tiger? Project Tiger is to save the tigers. Okay, so government, they have started Project Tiger, that is to save tiger. Next, they have made wildlife parks and wildlife sanctuaries. Why are these made? This is to provide natural and safe environment to the animals. Next, Vana Mahotsava. Okay, what is this? It is an awareness program to make aware about the benefits of trees in our life. Such programs have been started. And in these programs, what they do? They plant many plants. Okay, many plants are being planted in this program. And again, reforestation or even afforestation has been started. Okay, what is it? This is where a large number of trees are being planted. If we follow all these, we can save our plants and animals in the nature. So this is now the end of the lesson. I hope you read through the lesson once again and it will be more clear to you. Thank you.